What's up guys, Sal here. So ARM has officially announced its new Cortex A78 architecture along with the extra performance Cortex X1 cores. And let me explain why it's great news for Samsung and their Exynos team. You see, at this point, you should be aware that Exynos processors are inferior when compared with Apple's A-series Bionic and Qualcomm Snapdragon chipsets. They're inferior both in CPU as well as in GPU. Samsung has managed to keep this fact relatively hidden for years now, but the Exynos 990 is the final straw that broke the camel's back. There is a generational gap in the performance of the Exynos 990 and its counterpart Snapdragon 865. To fix this, Samsung has partnered with AMD to bring their Radeon graphics to Exynos, which by the leaked benchmarks that we saw a few weeks ago, managed to totally destroy the Adreno 650 GPU found in the Snapdragon 865. The AMD GPU outperformed the Adreno by a factor of 3, which is huge by the way. So judging by the numbers, we can safely say Samsung is gonna address the issues we had with the GPU department of the Exynos. But what about the CPU department? After all, CPU is more important than GPU. Well, for that, Samsung has fired their Mongoose team in Austin, who are responsible for custom M cores in Exynos chipsets. These M cores were powerful, but the main problem with them was they get hot so quickly, and as a result, the device starts throttling, which then reduces the performance of the chip. So to address this, Samsung ditched these custom cores altogether, and going forward, will use ARM stock cores. Now, Qualcomm also uses ARM stock cores, but with a little modification. That modification is the custom in-house Cairo cores where Qualcomm further optimizes the stock cores to get high performance. So that means with stock cores only, Samsung is never gonna beat Qualcomm in CPU department. Yes, they can beat them in GPU with AMD, but in CPU with stock cores, it's not possible. But wait, before you get disappointed, let me break the great news. ARM also unveiled a brand new high-performance Cortex X1 cores along with the Cortex A78. The A78 is 20% faster than the A77, but the Cortex X1 on the other hand is 30% faster than the A77. ARM made this Cortex X1 as a response to the further customized and optimized chips that you find on Apple's A-series and Qualcomm Snapdragon chipsets. Qualcomm is not going to use the Cortex X1 because they already have custom Cairo cores. Similarly, Apple is not going to use it either. So that leaves Samsung's Exynos chip line, which will most likely use this high-performance cores, that will help Exynos go toe-to-toe with Qualcomm in the CPU department as well. This also explains why Samsung ditched their Mongoose team. They probably realized it's not worth spending billions of dollars in research and development into these high-performance cores when ARM is basically making one too, and they can directly source from them instead of spending billions. By the way, Google is also dropping Snapdragon in favor of Exynos chips for Pixel phones next year with Google's own Pixel Visual Core and Titan Security Silicon. So Pixel phones are gonna benefit from this new X1 cores as well. So basically, this new extra performance Cortex X1 core is indeed great news for Samsung and as well as for all the consumers, because this will help decrease the monopoly of Qualcomm Snapdragon, as it will create competition between these two companies. And competition is super important, as it is what breeds innovation and drives down the price of new tech. Let me know what you think about this down in the comments. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.